Okay, so today we will study about the applications of steady flow energy equation. That we have already studied in our last class, and the steady flow energy equation and its application in the different processes like constant temperature process, constant pressure process, polytropic process, then reversible process, as well as reversible adiabatic. And we have also got the expression for the work done. Now today we will study the applications of this steady flow energy equation for the different thermodynamic devices, because the most of the devices are working on the principle of steady flow or in the open system. So there are a lot of applications in the working of steady flow energy equation in these devices. So first device we are taking is the nozzle. So I think you have heard the name nozzle. And what is a nozzle? As you can see here from this picture, actually nozzle is a passage of a varying cross section, and by means of which the pressure energy of flowing fluid is changed into kinetic energy. Actually, it is the main feature of the nozzle. It converts the pressure energy into the kinetic energy. The main use of the nozzle is to produce a jet of high velocity. This jet is obtained from the nozzle, and this is used to drive turbine and maybe to produce thrust. So here you can see this is the whole structure shown. That's the nozzle, and the fluid is getting entry from this side. So flow in is there, and the flow will leave from this side. So flow out, and you can see here the cross section area is varying of the data nozzle. Crossing area here from inlet section 1-1 to outlet section 2-2, it is decreasing first, then reaching to the minimum value, and then it is going to increase. So actually nozzle is a passage of the varying cross-sectional area. Then heat transfer here is zero, and the work done here is zero. So the flow of the fluid, which is having the high amount of the pressure energy, it is converted into the velocity or the kinetic energy. Also you can see also from this picture also, and here this is the converging inlet nozzle, this is the diffuser. Diffuser and nozzle both are just having the different structures, and also used for the same purposes, either to convert kinetic energy into pressure energy or pressure energy into kinetic energy. So first, what we do, apply the steady flow energy equation for this nozzle. So as you have seen that our steady flow energy equation is H1 plus C1 square by 2 plus DZ1 plus Q equal to H2 plus C2 square by 2 plus DZ2 plus W. This equation you have already studied. Here, in case of this nozzle, there is no heat transfer, so Q equal to 0. There is no change in potential energy, then this Z1 equal to 0, or Z1 equal to Z2, or Z1 minus Z2 equal to 0. So if we substitute these values in this equation, what we get? We get C2 equals to square root twice in bracket H1 minus H2 plus C2 square. As we know that enthalpy is a function of temperature, H equal to CP2. So from this we can write H1 minus H2 equal to CP T1 minus T2. So here from this relation, C2, which is the exit velocity for the nozzle, equal to square root twice H1 minus H2 plus C1 square, where C1 is the initial velocity in the nozzle. So here, if we say here the velocity is C1 at the nozzle here, and at the outlet side, the velocity is C2. Enthalpy here will be H1, and enthalpy here will be H2. Similarly, we can also write, and maybe the pressure energy, the pressure like P1, here the pressure will be P2. Similarly, we can also write temperature at the inlet is T1, at this temperature at the outlet will be T2. Similar value can be taken, but consider this, there is no work done in the nozzle as well as there is no heat transfer in the nozzle. Considering these things, putting these values, we have got this relation. Now,
हमारे ऐसे ही आते हैं।
नाउ हियर C2 इज इक्वल टू ऑल्सो ट्वाइस Cp T1 माइनस T2 प्लस C1 स्क्वायर। जस्ट वी हैव सब्स्टिट्यूटेड दिस वैल्यू फ्रॉम हियर H1 माइनस H2 इक्वल्स टू Cp T1 माइनस T2 सब्स्टिट्यूटिंग हियर एंड फर्दर दिस ट्वाइस Cp वी हैव टेकन आउट T1 हियर इट इज P2 बाय P1 टू द पावर गामा माइनस 1 अपॉन गामा। यू हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड फॉर द रिवर्सल एडियाबेटिक प्रोसेस दैट TYP to the power gamma minus 1 upon gamma equal to C, or we can also write that this is the T1 upon T1 to the power gamma minus 1 upon gamma, which is equal to T2 by P2 to the power gamma minus 1 upon gamma. So from this relation, we can also write what is will be the T2 by T1. So this T2 by T1 will be equals to P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 upon gamma. P2 by P1 whole to the power gamma minus 1 upon gamma. So actually what we have done here, from this relation which is showing T1 and T2, just we have taken T1 as the from the outside from this bracket, and then it gives twice Cp T1 1 minus P2 by P1 whole to the power gamma minus 1 upon gamma plus C1 square. So either if also considering if C1 is 0, C1 is the initial velocity at the nozzle is 0, then the final equation for the nozzle is for the axial velocity C2 is equal to square root twice H1 minus H2, which is equal to square root twice Cp T1 in bracket 1 minus P2 by P1 whole to the power gamma minus 1 upon gamma. So this expression is obtained for the nozzle when we apply the steady flow energy equation. So after taking the nozzle, we are taking the diffuser. So diffuser is a structure which is similar to the nozzle, but in this diffuser, the difference is that here the kinetic energy changes into the pressure energy, just opposite to the nozzle. So here you can see from this picture, fluid will in from this side, leave from this side. There is no change in the heat, so Q is equal to 0. There is no work done, so W is equal to 0. And the dashed line is indicating the control surface as well as control volume. But here you will see the area of this passage of this device is increasing. It means area is increasing, so it will convert kinetic energy into the pressure energy. This is the function of the diffuser. When we will apply this expression for this diffuser, we obtain the deep expressions H2 minus H1 equal to C1 square minus C2 square by 2, or this is written as Cp T1 in bracket T1 to the power gamma is 1 upon gamma minus 1 equal to C1 square minus C2 square by 2. So this is similar to the that is used for the in case of the nozzle. So that can be used. Now next one is we can take next device is the boiler. Okay, so for the boiler you have already studied in your BME the function of the boiler, and the boiler is used to convert the water into steam. So in the boiler, what happens, the chemical energy of the fuel is released by the combustion process in the form of heat, and this energy is used to generate steam from water at constant pressure, and which steam is used either to drive the steam turbine or maybe for the other industrial process or the other work. So the boiler is used to generate the steam or to convert the water into steam. If you generally simply see the process or the structure of the boiler, so this dashed line shows the control surface. So the first thing is there is the entry of the air in the boiler, which is the air is used to combustion or in the combustion chamber. There is the entry of the fuel. So fuel is burned in the combustion chamber. Air is there, fuel is there. The combustion will take place. and by the combustion it will release some energy, and that energy is used to convert water into steam. So water will get entry from this side, and after passing through different process we get the superheated steam. So water is getting in and steam is getting out from the boiler. So across or through this control surface or control volume there is the entry of the fluid. There is no work done in the boiler, but there is entry of the heat. Heat is added in the boiler. So what do we find here? If we are going to apply the steady flow energy equation, H1 plus U square by 2 plus DZ1 plus Q equal to H2 plus CT square by 2 plus DZ2 plus W. In this case, because there is no work done, so W equals to 0. And also, if we consider changes in kinetic energy and potential energy, both are negligible. So these two terms will also be eliminated.
Then zero. Or eliminated.
Q will be equal to H2 minus H1. So we find this is amount of the heat transfer in the boiler. We find this expression. And if we find it for the whole process, whole boiler, then this H2 minus H1 is multiplied by the mass M to find the total amount of the heat transfer. So just what we do in the boiler, there is the entry of the water. Water is converted into the steam. But to convert the water into steam, some heat is added. And that heat is released when the combustion of the fuel takes place. So this is the application of the SFE in case of the boiler. And next we are going to take the turbine. So turbine kya hai? Turbine is a device that converts the heat energy into mechanical energy or the useful work. This is the conversion of the heat energy into turbine. So what happens? The work energy level of the working fluid decreases continuously along the flow of steam. You can see this figure, and from this figure, and you can see the different process. But what we have considered first is change in kinetic energy negligible. So there is K equal to 0. If the kinetic energy that equals to 0, change in potential energy negligible. So P equal to 0 or change in P equal to 0. Also, the heat transfer is also negligible because all turbine is thermally insulated. It means that Q is also equal to 0. So if we put all these values here for the turbine, and applying this equation, we get this is the equation, and here we will apply the condition this Q equal to 0, and this change in kinetic energy is also 0, change in potential energy is also 0, and applying these all condition, we get this expression for the work done, which is W equal to H1 minus H2 kilojoules per kg. And for the total work output, we can write or we can multiply this term by the M. Working is already clear. Here you can see the high pressure gas, it is entering the turbine, it will enter the turbine, and this high pressure gas across these turbine blades will move, and it will convert its energy into the mechanical work. So on this shaft, mechanical work or the power is obtained. Okay, then after producing this work, the steam at the low pressure will leave this system. So there is the entry of the high pressure gas and leaving of the low pressure gas. So the enthalpy will change. Suppose if at the high pressure gas is entering, let this is having the enthalpy H1. High pressure gas here leaving the system, that its enthalpy is H2. So what change is occurring? It is H1 minus H2. This is the change of enthalpy, and this change of enthalpy is equal to the WT, where WT is the turbine work. So turbine work is obtained as H1 minus H2. Definitely H1 will be greater than H2 because H1 is the high pressure gas. So it is having the high amount of energy. But after doing the work, its energy level will decrease. It is the H2. So H1 minus H2 will be positive, and we get some work output from this turbine. And next device is the condenser. So the purpose of condenser is to convert the steam into water. So first try to understand, it is to condense the steam by rejecting heat from the steam to the cooling water. And actually for the power plant, it is one of the main elements of steam power plant. and about 55% energy is lost in condenser. And in the condenser there are two main flow streams. One is for the steam and another for the cooling water. So in simple way we can say what we are doing. And here in case of the condenser, from the top side you can see steam is written here. So the steam will enter in this cell. Steam will enter here in this cell. Steam is having a high amount of energy, and steam will pass through this condenser and will leave as the water. In the hot well there will be no steam, but steam will be converted to water. So there is the phase change will occur from the liquid, so from the steam, which is the gaseous phase, to the water, which is the liquid phase. Now another stream is water. So water is here and water is moving through these passages, and water is passing through all these tubes. Water is passing and following this passage here, water will leave. So the entry of the water at the inlet is, it is the cold water. Cold water will get entry in the condenser, and when the water will pass here, water will take heat from the steam. Water will take heat from the steam which is coming here, and so at the outlet we get the hot water or the warm water, because its temperature will rise. So here there is the heat exchange from the steam to the water, and the phase of the steam will change from the steam to the liquid water. So the purpose of this condenser. In this condenser also there is no work done. So this W = 0, there is no change in kinetic energy. So we can say KE = 0, no change in potential energy. So we write here E = 0. And when we apply all these terms, we get the amount of heat transferred or heat extracted from the steam will be equal to H1 minus H2 kilojoules per kg. So this is the amount of heat extracted. This is the expression for the condenser. You can also write it for the whole amount of heat transfer. So just you have to multiply by this and you will get the total amount of the heat transferred in the condenser. And opposite to the condenser, as we in case of the condenser, there is the phase change occurs, and because of that the steam is converted to the water. But in the evaporator it is just opposite. Suppose we are having the water in a container. If we give heat to the water, and definitely water will evaporate. Water will change its phase, and if it is occurring at the pressure and temperature, that is the saturation temperature, then this device is called as the evaporator. It will require only the latent heat. So in the evaporator there is also using the reference system. Either there may be for the water, maybe for the freon gas, or maybe for the another substance. The purpose of evaporator to make the phase change by adding heat to the substance. So in this case there is no work done. So W = 0, no change in kinetic and potential energy. Again here we will write KE = 0 = PE. These two terms are also zero here. And when we will apply this equation for this steady flow energy equation, we get Q = H2 - H1. And here you can see the difference. Here H2 = H1 + Q. So here H2 is greater than H1. Because H1 equal to the liquid phase. Some liquid will be there in the evaporator. And H2, when it is getting heat for the evaporation, it will require heat. It will be converted into the vapor phase. So liquid is changing here from liquid to vapor. Phase change will occur, and this phase change will require some heat. Here H2 equal to H1 plus Q, which is the amount of heat taken. So it gives Q equal to H2 minus H1, but in case of the condenser, it is just different. Q equal to H1 minus H2. So in the case of the condenser, in the case of the evaporator, the heat transfer is different. Okay, in the evaporator, heat is added, and in that case, heat is rejected in case of the condenser. And next, you have also already gone through practical the reciprocating compressor, and the purpose of compressor is to compress the air or gas from low pressure to high pressure. This is the purpose of the using compressor. So we have just have to increase the pressure. And when we will apply this equation H1 plus U square by 2 plus GZ1 plus Q equal to H2 plus U square by 2 plus GZ2 plus W. But what we do here, W is not zero here because some amount of work input is necessary to convert or to change the pressure. And we use some compressor, we use some electric input in that. We run the compressor by giving the electric input. So that electric input converts the electrical energy into the mechanical energy. So this W work is required, it's important. So as well as here Q is also negative because there may be some chances that the heat may be rejected because the when the air will be compressed, it's a temperature and pressure will increase. Even the compressor may be insulated, but some heat it will lose to the surrounding. When it is losing heat, so heat rejection will be there, and heat rejection from the system is taken as negative. So the work input required in the compressor is written as H1 minus H2 minus Q. Other terms are neglected. And if we are also neglecting Q, if there is a very small change in the heat or the heat rejection, then we write W is equal to H1 minus H2, or total work done W equal to M into H1 minus H2. So either term can be used for the calculation of the work input required. So these are the some applications or important applications we have discussed and applying the steady flow energy equation. And you can also apply for any other device which you have or which you can see. And considering all these points, somewhere may Q equal to 0, in some device may W equal to 0, in some device C1 equal to 0, etc. And you can find the expression for the any type of device. Now, this is the simple application we have done. Now, we will solve some questions so that we will be clear about application of this steady flow energy equation. So, in the chat box, just I will drop some question so that you have to do. So first I am taking, suppose I am taking a question over this boiler. I have just added a question in the chat box. Rohit, can you see my question? Rohit, ja.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Chat box. Mein.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, just you can read this question and you will see the question is in a boiler, water enters with an enthalpy of 160 kilojoules per kg. And steam leaves with the enthalpy of 2925 kilojoules per kg. You have to find the heat transferred per kg of steam. The changes in kinetic and potential energy may be neglected. So this is the question. Okay. Now, if we are going to solve this question, so I'm going to just share it on the screen. So, and in this question, whatever the given, you have to write first. So, in this question, this is the question of the boiler. And in the boiler only heat transfer is there, which is considered. And the both the amount of enthalpies are given in the question, which are the H1 as well as H2. So, what is the given? What is the value of H1? 168. Okay. You are getting my boys? What is H2? 2925. Sandeep and Rohit, are you getting my voice? Okay, so these are the two values. Now, from steady flow energy equation, we can write H1 plus C1 square by 2 plus GZ1 plus Q, and that equal to H2 plus C2 square by 2 plus GZ2 plus W. So from this equation, just we will obtain Q equal to H2 minus H1, because what happens in this case, you will write W equal to 0, there is no work done, and del KE equal to 0 equal to del PE. So just you have to put the value. Q equal to H2 is given 2925 minus 168. This gives you Q equal to 2757 kilojoules per kg. Sandeep, you are getting my voice?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I'm getting your voice, sir.
Yes, sir.
You can get a reply. Eh? Okay, so we have got this relation simply as a heat. This is equal to 257 kilojoules per kg. Now, I am going to give you another question. Another question is, because there are a lot of questions, you can solve any question.
Yes, sir.
Medical, you have the subject, it requires a lot of questions. Whatever the practice you can do, you can refer different types of books also. So just I am going to post this. Okay. Now, print this time. We need just to copy it.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now we'll solve this question. So the question says that steam enters a nozzle at a pressure of 7 bar and 28 grade. And its initial enthalpy is 2850 atmospheres per kg and leaves at a pressure of 1.5 bar. Initial velocity of steam at the entrance is 40 meters per second and at the exit velocity from the nozzle is 700 meters per second. The mass flow rate through the nozzle is 1400 kg per hour. The heat loss from the nozzle is 11705 kilojoules per hour. Final enthalpy of steam and the nozzle area. With the steam volume is 1.24 cubic meter per kg.
Thank you. Per kg.
When we are going to solve it, let me consider that we are having a nozzle here. Suppose we are having a nozzle. Yeah, this is the nozzle, and that this is having two sections. Inlet section, this section is a 1-1, and this is having the outlet section here. Let this section is 2-2. Now some values are given here, so you can see the values. And the initial pressure 7 bar, temperature 20 degree centigrade, straight to right. At the inlet side, the fluid will enter and it will leave here at this section. Here pressure P1 is equal to, given is 7 bar. Temperature T1, which is given is 20 degree centigrade. Velocity C1 is 40 meters per second. Enthalpy given is H1. I think 2850 kilojoules per kg. H1 is 2850, and this is kilojoules per kg. At the outlet side, pressure P2 given is, and this is 1.5 bar. And the velocity C2 is given as this is 700 meter per second. As well as there is some heat loss. So this is the Q. This Q equal to it is given 11,705 kilojoules per hour. As well as there is no work done, so we will write this W equal to zero here. And also the M is given. M dot is the mass flow rate. The mass flow rate which is given is 1400. This is kg per hour. It is given the question as well as mass flow rate as well as this is actually called the not mass, but it's called the specific volume. Specific volume. One point.
Kg.
So these terms are given. Now we have got from the equation of nozzle. From equation of nozzle, and you can write C2 equal to square root twice Cp T1 1 minus P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 upon gamma. So here the value of gamma equal to 1.4 you have to take, and Cp that we will take 1.005 kilojoules per kg Kelvin. Now T1 is P2 over gamma minus 1 upon gamma. T1 to the power gamma. So from this expression, actually P1 and P2 are known to us and T1 is known. So we can find T2 equals to into all the terms are known. This T1 is known, P2 is known, and P1 is known. You will get the T2. You will find T2. And when you will find T2, then from this relation, for the C2, you can find the axial velocity C2 from here, this relation. Because you are already knowing the value of Cp, T1 and P2 by P1. Now, next you have to find the axial area. So for the axial area, just we will use the continuity equation.
सर सीपी की वैल्यू गिवन है
द वैल्यू ऑफ द सीपी इज फिक्स्ड फॉर द परफेक्ट गैस इट इज 1.005
ओके सर नाउ सर केजी पर
हां नाउ सेकंड टर्म इज द एक्सिट एरिया फॉर विद बी यू बी सर डेंसिटी ए इज एरिया सी इज द वेलोसिटी और ऑल्सो रिटन एज ए इंटू सी बाई न्यू न्यू इज द स्पेसिफिक वॉल्यूम ऑल्सो वी कैन राइट रो वन ए वन सी वन फॉर एनी पैसेज दैट इज इक्वल टू रो टू ए टू सी टू
सी टू
एंड विच इज इक्वल टू कॉन्स्टेंट this is constant as per the continuity equation this is constant and this constant is equal to the mass flow rate mass flow rate so from here we have to find the exit area so we will have to go to a2 c2 equal to m dot which is constant so value is known to us then we can write a2 equal to this a2 equal to m dot and this is m dot upon
rho 2 c2
okay we are going to find a2 so was it a2 equal to this this m dot into and one upon rho 2
A2
upon C2. So actually M dot is constant, but one upon rho 2 mu 2 actually volume
mu 2
upon C2. So mu 2 is given to you. That is the specific volume, and its value is I think 1.24 cubic meter per kg. It is given in the question. It is the specific volume. Okay. And mass flow rate is also given and C2 already got C2 आपने अभी find ये found got C2 this relation and you will put all these values you will get the exit area okay so here you can get the exit area also you can find Actually, there are a lot of problems, and you have to go for the calculation. I will share you the solutions also, but calculation you have to do in your part. So you have to sit here in the class, taking your calculator, etc. And you have to calculate. I will just show you what is the procedure, what is the strategy, what you have to calculate. So in this way, approximately first over from tomorrow, I will start the unit 2. And have you any question at this time? I'm going to stop my sharing my screen. If you have any question, please ask. Yeah, please ask your question. Any one of you, if you have any question, please ask me.
Sir. सर जैसे एवेपरेटर सर विकास बोल रहा हूँ सर, एवेपरेटर में जैसे कि वर्क डन भी जीरो था और अपना काइनेटिक एनर्जी भी जीरो था, पोटेंशियल एनर्जी भी जीरो था, केवल क्यू था जो था एम वो क्यू स्मॉल क्यू था H2-H1 किलो जूल पर केजी। तो सर इसमें वर्क डन तो ठीक है पर इसमें सर काइनेटिक
you have seen the boiler, what happens in the boiler, actually boiler is also an evaporator, it converts water into steam.
Yes sir.
So there are changes in the kinetic energy, but these changes if are very very small then can be neglected. What happens in case of the boiler, we are adding a lot of amount of heat, okay?
Yes sir.
A lot of amount of heat, we add a high amount of heat, but in the steady flow energy equation, you use the enthalpy, which is H1. You write the potential energy, kinetic energy, and add heat addition in the left hand side of the equation. So actually, all the terms are the energy term, so that they can be added. But the enthalpy or the heat added or the and or the heat added, that is the Q. It is very very large in comparison to the change in potential and kinetic energy, then that can be neglected. Suppose you are making comparison 100 from 1. If you are making comparison 101, then you can neglect 1 because 1 is very small in comparison to 100.
Yes.
But in comparison to 100, you cannot neglect 10. So the values, then the change in kinetic and potential energy, that is very very small. So can be neglected. Exactly, it is not equal to 0, but we can neglect it because of the smaller value. Got it?
Yes.
The next class start ho gayi hai sir.
Okay, you can leave now. Okay, no problem. Anna, thank you.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
So we'll see you tomorrow. P2, our gamma minus one upon gamma. T1 minus T1 to the power. So from this expression, actually P1 and P2 are known to us and T1 is known. So we can find T2 equals to into all the terms are known. This T1 is known, P2 is known, and P1 is known. You will get the T2. You will find T2. And when you will find T2, then from this relation, for the C2, you can find the axial velocity C2 from here, this relation. Because you are already knowing the value of CP, T1 and P2 by P1. Now, next you have to find the exit area. So for the exit area, just we will use the continuity equation.
Sir, CP ki value given hai?
The value of the CP is fixed for the perfect gas. It is 1.005.
Okay, sir. Now, kg per?
Now, second term is the exit area for which we will use the continuity equation. Do you M of mass M dot equal to rho A C. Here rho is the density, A is area, C is the velocity, or also written as A into C by nu. The nu is the specific volume. Also, we can write rho 1, A 1, C 1 for any passage that is equal to rho 2, A 2, C 2.
C 2.
And which will be equal to constant. This is constant as per the continuity equation. This is constant, and this constant is equal to the mass flow rate. Mass flow rate. So from here we have to find the effect area. So we will write rho 2 A 2 C 2 equal to m dot, which is constant, so value is known to us. Then we can write A 2 equal to this A 2 equal to m dot, and this is m dot. Upon
rho 2 C 2.
Okay. We are going to find A 2. So what's it? A 2 is equal to this. This. M dot into and 1 upon rho 2
C 2
1 upon C 2. So actually M dot is constant, but 1 upon rho 2 mu 2, actually volume
mu 2
upon C 2. So mu 2 is given to you, that is the specific volume. And its value is, I think, 1.24 cubic meter per kg. It is given in the question. It is the specific force. Okay. And mass flow rate is also given. And C2 is already got. C2, you have found C2, this relation. When you will put all these values, you will get the actual area. Okay, so here you can get the exit area also. You can find. Actually, there are a lot of problems, and you have to go for the calculation. I will share you the solutions also, but calculation you have to do in your part. So you have to sit here in the class, taking your calculator, etc. And you have to calculate. I will just show you what is the procedure, what is the strategy, what you have to calculate. So in this way, approximately first over. From tomorrow, I will start the unit 2. And have you any question at this time? I'm going to stop my sharing my screen. If you have any question, please ask. Yeah, please ask your question. Any one of you, if you have any question, please ask me.
सर जैसे एवेपरेटर सर विकास बोल रहा हूँ सर एवेपरेटर में जैसे कि वर्क डन भी जीरो था और अपना काइनेटिक एनर्जी भी जीरो था पोटेंशियल एनर्जी भी जीरो था केवल क्यू था जो था एम वो क्यू स्मॉल क्यू था H2-H1 किलो जूल पर केजी तो सर इसमें वर्क डन तो ठीक है पर इसमें सर काइनेटिक
Yeah, your voice is not coming. Actually, You have seen the boiler. What happens in the boiler? Actually, boiler is also an evaporator. It converts water into steam.
Yes, sir.
So there are changes in the potential kinetic energy, but these changes are very, very small, then can be neglected. What happens in case of the boiler, we are adding a lot of amount of heat. Okay?
Yes, sir.
A lot of amount of heat, we add a high amount of heat, but in the steady flow energy equation, you use the enthalpy, which is H1, you write the potential energy, kinetic energy, and add heat addition in the left hand side of the equation. So actually all the terms are the energy terms, so that they can be added. But the enthalpy or the heat added that is the Q, it is very, very large in comparison to the change in potential and kinetic energy, then that can be neglected. Suppose you are making comparison 100 from 1. If you are making comparison 101, then you can neglect 1, because 1 is very small in comparison to 100.
Yes.
But in comparison to 100, you cannot neglect 10. So the values, there is the change in kinetic and potential energy, that is very, very small. So you can neglect it. Exactly, it is not equal to 0, but we can neglect it because of the smaller value.